So today we're going to talk about what exercise can do to your immune system. If you're doing regular, consistent exercise, you can greatly enhance your immune system. Number one, you'll have heightened immune surveillance. Now, what does that mean? Well, on the internal part of your body, you have a barrier. It's all the internal skin. And the size of that surface area would be about 400 square meters, the size of two tennis courts. And so you have immune cells, they're called phagocytes, that are guards that do surveillance. And they are constantly looking for invaders, pathogens, to actually come across the barrier, to attack them and eat them. So exercise will enhance your phagocyte protection and your defense mechanism. Number two, it'll increase lymph circulation. What is the lymphatic system? Well, you have the circulatory system, where blood is traveling through your arteries, and then it goes down into these small little capillaries, where the blood then can cross into your tissues, and it forms lymph. So the lymph system is like your backup system to the circulatory system. Then it goes all through the body through your lymph system, where then it dumps back into the circulatory system. So your lymph system is a backup to your circulatory system, as well as a place to consolidate immune reactions, to keep the immune reactions out of certain organs and tissues in a place where your immune system can then fight it more effectively. The problem with the lymph system is it doesn't have a pump. Exercise will increase the lymph flow through your body. Number three, exercise delays the negative effect of aging on your immune system. So the more exercise you do, the younger you're going to be, because what you have to realize is that as you age, your immune system gets weaker and weaker and weaker. In fact, the thymus gland, which is on top of the heart, which does all the training for the T cells, literally shrinks down to nothing when you become 80 years old. Number four, exercise can enhance the immune defense mechanisms as well as how fast your immune system responds to infection. And number five, and I think this is probably the most important thing, is exercise can reduce mental stress. And mental stress probably has the biggest influence on weakening your immune system, making you more susceptible to getting an infection. When you do exercise in the correct way, you can really lower the stress. The trick with exercise is to exercise in a way so as not to activate too much cortisol. And really, to do that, you just have to make sure you don't overtrain and you get enough sleep. The healthier you are and the more recovery you have, the less you have to worry about this. So certain people can do ultra marathons and actually not even have that phase their immune system. But other people that have higher levels of cortisol, which by the way suppresses the immune system, they can get sick even when they try to exercise a little bit. But for most people, doing regular, consistent exercise is extremely beneficial to your immune system. Thanks for watching.
Hey, we're back
with another amazing recipe.
No grains, no sugar, totally keto. There's no suffering in keto.
Absolutely not, Karen.
And it's an immune system builder.
Absolutely. You have to check this out.
I think you should hurry up, watch the recipe, and make it yourself. It's just so easy to be keto.
But is it simple?
It's super simple. We hope you enjoy making it as much as we are enjoying eating it.